रमेश घनमोडे आता तुमच्याशी बोलेल. त्यांनी 2014-15 प्रिपरेटरी वीकेंड कोर्स केलेला आहे, 2015-16 यू पी एस सी कॉम्प्रिहेन्सिव्ह कोर्स केलेला आहे, त्याचा ऑप्शनल पॉल सायन्स आहे. यू पी एस सी सिव्हिल सर्व्हिसेस एक्झॅमिनेशनमध्ये मुलाखत त्यांनी दिलेली आहे. त्यांचं बी ई इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स अँड टेलिकम्युनिकेशनमध्ये झालेलं आहे आणि ते आता तुमच्याशी इंटरनॅशनल रिलेशन्स आणि ऑप्शनल पॉलिटिकल सायन्स या विषयावर बोलतील.
थँक्यू सौदामिनी. गुड आफ्टरनून एव्हरीबडी. सब्जेक्ट गिवन टू मी आर बेसिकली टू थिंग्स. फर्स्ट आय हॅव टू टॉक यू अबाउट international relations in our GS2 paper, which is a mandatory paper for everybody, irrespective of your optional. And the second thing I'm going to talk about is basically introduction to the Pol Science and International Relation optional, which is often called as PSIR. Now let's talk about the mandatory part, IR in GS2. So basically for any nation's foreign policy, and especially for India, there are two purposes of foreign policy of any country. That is basically to serve our interest in current global order, and second, which sir often talk to us about, is basically India aspires to be a leader of the world, okay, in every aspect, mind you, not just in the case parameter of population. So we have to serve as a comprehensive leader of the world. Let's talk about the I'm going to decode the IR for GS2. So basically, we have to study IR in with respect to following four points. First one of them is basically the bilateral relations of India with its neighborhood and all the major powers in the world. We have to study IR according to that. Second pillar is basically something known as multiple grouping, how India serves its interest, how India operates on the multilateral forums like ASEAN, BRICS, BIMSTEC, as well as WTO, that we have to study. Then the third pillar is basically something known as global institution, that is also part of our syllabus. So global institution we need to study in detail, especially the important ones, starting from United Nations to various its allied organizations and all G20 and all those things. UPSC is frequently asking question on at least one or two question in GS2 paper on global institutions. Then the fourth pillar basically we need to study in IR is basically we need to study what are the current global important issues and its impact on India, how India is going to deal with them. So issues like basically climate change and its impact on India, refugee crisis, again a burning issue in current global order, then something known as, you might have heard about anti-globalization, or globalization is facing some setback due to rising protectionist trends in world. So, mind you, in all those four pillars, we need to study them, especially from one perspective, that is what's India's interest in them and how they're going to impact India. And then what, how we need to analyze them, like how India is going to tackle them, how is India is tackling currently them. So that's the way we need to study them. Then how to make notes about it and how to study them. And also I'm going to tell you about these some sources, basic sources. So most important source for IR is nothing based than newspapers, okay, whatever coming in newspaper, especially the articles of foreign policy expert, then distinguished diplomats and also former diplomats. So that we need to make notes from, and those are the best sources. If you want some basic sources so that you will get a historical perspective of India's relation, India's foreign policy, you can read, you can choose any one book of like available books are like Rajiv Sikri and Shyam Saran. They are coming up with their book. Both are India's former foreign secretary. Then Shashi Tharoor, you know, his book known as Pax Indica is also good. Any one of them, or choose any current book of former diplomat, which will give a brief idea, which will give a base for international relation. But again, I'm highlighting once again, the newspaper is the best import, best source for this. Another source, and I found very good for this, is something known as Rajya Sabha TV's programs, especially the two, The Big Picture and India's World. Over there, they discuss a lot of contemporary issues related to the IR, and they discuss, unlike many other news channels, they discuss in a very polite way. So the panel is always distinguished over there, esteemed panel. So these are also important sources. But make one thing sure, that you have to make notes out of all this. I mean, you read and you feel like you are expert in IR, but that's not going to last more than 7 or 8 days. You're going to forget that. So making notes, issue-based, is very important for IR. That's only help you in the time of examination. Then another important thing about this IR is one thing I find very good, that you should collect some good quotes, okay, which will help you to summarize the issue, summarize the question asked. Like a question comes on India-USA changing relation, then when Prime Minister Modi went to the USA, he used one quote over there, because at that time, now currently as we are sitting over here, India-USA relations are going through some uncertainty, but especially the last 2 years of Barack Obama was heydays of India-USA relations, and at that time, Prime Minister Modi used quotes like, India-USA relation moving from estranged democracy to engaged democracy. So those kind of quotes always help you. Another quote like, how India should deal with its neighborhood, the quote of our former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he says, we can change our friends, but we can't change our neighbors. So those kind of quote will always help you to summarize the question. Like another example I can give you, when that One Road, One Belt initiative of China was there, when that summit was happening, and there was questions like, why India is not joining that? So MEA statement says, it's very clearly, in only one statement they were summarizing it, they were saying, yes, connectivity is important for us, but for the sake of connectivity, we can't compromise our sovereignty, because one element of that OBR was going from POK without consultation to India. So those kind of quotes, you know, will differentiate your paper from others. So try to collect them, especially the quotes of Prime Minister, former foreign secretaries, and also some foreign policy experts. Now let's move to something known as this PSIR optional, its introduction. So let me very clearly tell you why people these days increasingly taking this optional. Basically two reasons. First, it's easy to understand. It's relatively easy to understand. It's more or less linked to our day-to-day life. So people try, people find it very easy. So people go for it. And second reason, very important, is basically PSIR overlaps the most with other GS papers. As compared to any other optional in the system, PSIR overlaps most. I mean, take example of GS1 over there, post-independence history and world history, societal issues are we study in PSIR. Then almost 60-70 part of GS2 we study in PSIR, GS3 also, and on GS4 and SA, this philosophical and political philosophy we study in PSIR comes very handy while writing answers. So that's why people try to take this optional. So let me introduce itself to you first, what are its basic element of PSIR. So basically, like any other optional, there are two papers and four sections. First section of paper one is basically something known as political theory. Over there, we have to study different values like equality, liberty, rights, justice. Then we need to study various political philosophies like communism, socialism, Gandhism, feminism. Apart from that, we have to study political thoughts, both Western, starting from Plato to Marx, Hannah Arendt, and then Indian political thought, again starting from Chanakya, Buddhist political thought to probably what say Mahatma Gandhi and Dr. Ambedkar. So all that we have to study in the political perspective. That is paper one, section one for you. Paper one, section two consists of Indian government and politics. So basically, most of its area is from polity. So whatever ma'am talked to you about, what consists of 60% of this section two. But there are other things as well, like you have to study the political perspectives on our national struggle. Then we also need to study various movements, like environmental movements in India, the peasant movement, trade union movement, environmental movement, human rights, and all those social movements from political perspective. That is the additional part in this paper one, section two. Then let's move to the paper two, section one, which is known as comparative politics and international relations. this section is again like section 1 is a theory portion of this paper. Over here we need to study the approaches in comparative politics. It's a kind of theoretical thing. Then various theories of international relations like realist school, liberal school, Marxist school, we need to study over here. Apart from that, various global issues like democracy, rights, all that we have to study from the comparative way we have to study. We have seen democracy, rights, social movements in section 1 as well. But over here, we need to study it in comparative way, comparing with the other constitutions and other countries in the world. Section 4, which kindles interest of most of you, is something known as India's world. Okay, the last section of this paper, India's world. Over here, once again, we need to study the foreign policy of India in broad. But along with that, a lot of theoretical things are here as well, like what are the determinants of Indian foreign policy, which are the key stakeholders who are going to decide what our foreign policy would be, think tanks in India, all that thing we need to study over here. But let me tell you, I told you two important things about why people opt for pol science and IR. But these two very things can go against choosing PSIR as well. I mean, it may give you some setback if you're taking it and not considering these two things. That first, I say it's an overlapping paper, but make one thing clear in your mind. Though it's overlapping, the answer writing skill and study skills and the command you want to require in this PSIR is way different than the other GS papers. You need to have a consolidation over here, so it's can't get in the same way. So that's why overlapping is there, but the approach should be subtly different from GS and between this pol science optional. Second thing I was talking about, this optional is very easy to understand. It's relatively easy to understand. But that doesn't mean it will do the trick for you, because just understanding the optional is not sufficient. You need to have a command over it. You need to consolidate the optional. You need to have a n number of revisions for it. Then only you will be able to score in the actual mains examination. So though these two things go into the favor of this PSIR, but keep these two things in your mind. And as Pujadai said in the very beginning, that micro notes for this optional are very important, because the syllabus or the volume of this optional is huge. So you need to make notes, then only you will be able to revise it before the actual papers. Then, of course, another important thing, syllabus you should know. As Thai said, unless you this syllabus is by heart to you, it's going to be very difficult, and you are asking for trouble, sir, otherwise. Now let me talk very briefly about the sources. So you got the idea, like this optional is very much dynamic, especially the section 2 of both the papers are very much dynamic. The relevance of current affairs in this optional is huge. So newspaper is going to be there, and you have to make those kind of notes for this optional. Another thing people ask basically, should we use notes or not for this optional? Like there are ready-made notes in market. So I'll say notes are good, okay, you should use them, but you should supplement it with the books as well. I mean, the syllabus is huge, so there's high chances that if you are not using notes, if you are going by books, your preparation may go haywire, okay? To keep it on track, these notes will help you. So use those notes as a base material for your preparation. Now, sometimes you may find difficulty with notes, because those notes are written for the people who are sitting in those classrooms. So if you are reading it outside of those classes, then you may find difficulty in comprehending them. So for those, you have to use books. And there's always a section-wise book list for this optional. So I'll quickly go through that. So for section 1, basically, people use books like... So IGNU material, IGNU MA material, is good for all the sections, especially the static portion, theory portion, you can cover it from there. Other sources for paper 1, section 1 is basically O.P. Gauba. People can also use Andrew Haywood. So use one of them. Raju Bhargava's book, Political Theory, is also good. Use one of them and strictly use them according to syllabus. Don't try to read everything from the book. Second, another, again, new current affairs and the Oxford publication on Indian politics, which is edited by Pratap Bhanu Mehta and Nirja Gopal Jayal. It's another series of good essays which you can refer from. It will help you to consolidate that portion. For section 3, basically paper 2, section 1, the important book is known as Andrew Haywood's Global Politics. You can read it selectively. For comparative politics, you may use the IGNU MA book. For the last section, the IR section, again, all these things which we discussed, like newspaper articles, the books of, at least the book reviews of these books on international relations. You need to study them very nicely. Some interviews you need to go through. And all those things will make your content unique and some kind of differentiated content than other which are giving exam with you. So that's all about PSIR. Thank you.